Hey, what's up, y'all? What's up? Back at it again, man. Got some EPMD playing now, man. Is that loud enough? Yeah. Anyway, I'm cool with it. All right, y'all. So we're back. Back at it again. So took a little bit of time, man. Went and got me some Kool-Aid and cleaned up this blog post a little bit that I got from the that I purchased from this this new writer that I met in a blogging forum. You know, she's really rough around the edges, so I do see value in people, and I see value in what people offer. So I'm not gonna just say, hey, I'm not gonna use you at all, but I am gonna work with her to help her get better. So, because we don't get bitter, we get better, baby. All right. So let me go ahead and let's pull up the, let me show you the post, kind of what I cleaned up. Okay, cool. All right, so if you recall, I started off kind of talking about what a good post needs to look like. It needs to have an H1 tag, and the H1 tag needs to have the keyword within the H1. So it needs to have the keyword within the title. In the title tag, you need to have the keyword within the URL. It's just like if you think about an English outline or paper, an outline that you would do for a paper, you want to just take it down like that, outline like that. So H1, major headline, subheadline, sub, and so on. So I always like to do the second headline. I like to be a variation of the keyword. Third is an H3. I like that to be another variation of the keyword. I always like to ask a question, because Google in itself is a query. You know, why do people come to Google? They come to Google for a search, for an answer. So it's an answer to a question. You have the what's called know, see, and do. So people either want to know something, they want to see something. I'm sorry, know, see, or do. Know, do, or buy. So, they want to buy something. So that's generally what we want to build a post around those particular intents, the buyer intent or the searcher intent, what the searcher is actually looking for. And we can actually figure that out, or we can drive that by conversion rate optimization. And we'll go over that later. Not in today's post. That's a little bit more advanced SEO. Okay, so if you recall looking at the first post, it was a little bit shorter. That was about 350 words. I added another couple hundred words to it. You know, I added, you know, a question, how do you prevent dry hair? I did a little bit of research, just what causes dry hair, you know, what causes dry hair. You know, and it's funny when you write content like this. It's amazing how much you learn about all these different topics. So I learned about roofing, I learned about hair, obviously, you know, heart failure, you name it. So I know I could ramble, right? But anyway, all right, so kind of going through this post. So we got the what's the best treatment for dry hair, because remember, that's your keyword, best treatment for dry hair. And I want to seed that keyword throughout the post. Best treatments for dry hair. Okay. And in the H4, I want to have best treatment for dry hair. I'm sure I have it in here another variation. Good treatment for dry hair. So good treatment is latentness in LSI, or latent somatic indicator. It's a good sentiment keyword. So you have best, good, top. Those are all good sentiment keywords. So good is similar to best. So if that makes sense. All right. So the next thing we want to do is we want this page to be linked in or tied into some other pages on the site, because generally this is an informational site. As you can see, there's no real product that's being sold on the site. It's just really just a general information, just a site you know, take care of your health. That's the name of it. So I'm going to try to make this link with interlinking as helpful as possible. Okay. So as I was kind of doing a little bit of research, I saw that there's a home remedy for dry hair, and that includes apple cider vinegar. So, and where is that at? Let's go. There you go. Apple cider vinegar. Now, oddly enough, or funny enough, we actually have another post in here about apple cider vinegar. So let me go to takecareforhealth.com. I'm going to type in apple cider. And there you go. Apple cider vinegar for skincare. And I know in here we talk about apple cider vinegar for skin, pimples, blah, 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 and so on. So I'm going to go here, and I'm actually going to create a hyperlink or an anchor text. So I'm going to anchor back apple cider vinegar back to this apple cider vinegar for skincare. So we have these posts that are tied in together. So now how did I do that? How did I just do this? I highlighted the apple cider vinegar. I clicked on the link, insert a link, and then I pasted the URL in that space. Okay. Let me see. Now we also, I think that it would be good because this is about an informational post. I think it would be good if we put a link for something that would people normally wouldn't know about. So as I kind of read through the post, something that jumped out to me was oxidative stress. So that's something that I'm sure someone would probably want to know about. Oxidative stress. What is oxidative stress? Also, you may notice that I'm keeping I don't have any hyperlinks above the fold of the page within the first paragraph or anything, because the reason why is I'm trying to bring the traffic, the attention to the keyword. I'm not going to pull anything away from this blog post. I'm going to weigh it down with the keyword right at the beginning. So oxidative stress. So let me copy. Now let's get a definition for what oxidative stress is. There you go. Oxidative stress is essentially an imbalance between the production of free radicals. There you go, man. So I'm going to click on this. Let's go to Healthline. Everything you should know about oxidative stress. So I'm going to copy this URL. It talks about how you can prevent oxidative stress and what everything about it. So now I have that. I'm going to go to my post, and I have oxidative stress highlighted. Paste. Boom. Now, something I'm going to do about this, whenever I link out from the site and link to another site, I always want to make that link a nofollow link. And why do I want to make a nofollow link? Because I want to keep my link authority. I want to keep all the page authority on the page as much as possible. If I do want to have page authority, I want to be able to pass it around to other pages within the site. So I'm going to put in a rel equals nofollow. Okay. Now, the next thing we need to do, you notice I'm going to do this in category, is we're going to do, this is going to go under, let's see, beauty tips. Let's call it beauty tips. Okay. Because, yeah, I got to stay beautiful. All right. The next thing we want to do is we want to have an image. So I've already selected an image. I'm going to go to upload the file. Let's see if I have it over here. How to treat dry hair. So the title for the image, I want to have the keywords. I want to have some of the keywords within the image, within the title. So treat dry hair, best way to treat dry hair, that's in the image. So treat dry, I mean, in the kits, part of the keyword. So treat dry hair, there you go. So alt tag, the alt text is another way for someone who is visually impaired to be able to see, to know what this image is about. So I'm going to say, all right. Okay. There we go. So now we have an image of a lady with dry hair. And so next thing down here in the what's called the rich snippet or snippet preview or the meta, we want to put the keyword. So the keyword again was best treatment for dry hair. And I asked, do you have dry hair? From egg whites to shine away from hair drying. There's a best treatment for dry hair for everyone. Here are a few tips. Okay. And then of course the URL says that. I got it here. And let's look at the readability analysis. Let's look at that, man. We've got a happy face, happy face. So if you can't get a happy face all the time, that's okay. Now, if you have Yoast Premium, there's actually gives you some insights to let you know, hey, what's this? Is this post about what you want it to be about? Treatment for dry hair, best treatment for dry hair, allowing the hair dry, and so on. So there you go. So next thing we're going to do, now that we have all the posts together, is we are going to publish it. Okay, so it's going to publish. And guess what we do next? Let's go take a look at it. Oh, wow. There you go, man. Best room for dry hair. I like to keep the links off the site, especially if something like this, an informational page. I like to keep my links on the site down to a minimum, unless I'm really trying to move. Unless the whole purpose of the page is to move link authority around. Really, I like to keep the links on the page to a minimum. So. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to go and submit this link, this URL to Search Console. So, because we want Google to crawl this. So, Google Search Console. Using Search Console. And we're going to go to Take Care for Health. Okay. And we're going to submit this URL. And it says, obviously, the URL is not on Google because we just created it. So we're going to request that it index. Okay. Next thing I'm going to go is I'm going to go to my keyword tracker. And when I get to my keyword tracker, I am going to go to Take Care for Health. And I'm going to put this keyword in here. So I'm going to go to Monitor Rankings. I like to track my keywords. And SEO Profile is a great way to do that. When you track your keywords, you're tracking, you're tracking how well your site's performing. Are you doing, you know, if how were your pages doing versus the other keywords? Are there any adjustments that you need to make, et cetera? Some things that you can also see, that information through Google Search Console. So this is just another crutch I like to use. So they normally say it's not good to use crutches, but man, I don't know. I kind of like this crutch. So I'm going to go type in best treatment for dry hair. And this is what's called a long tail keyword. So treatment for dry hair. Dry hair would be a short keyword. Treatment for dry hair, or treatment for dry hair would be more of intent keyword. Best treatment for dry hair would, of course, be, it's a long tail keyword, and that is really about a knowing. You want to, that's the information that you want to know about. So you want to know, hey man, I got dry hair. What's the best treatment for my dry hair? So there you go. So now I'm also going to submit this to Bing Webmaster. Oh, we need to add it in here, man. HTTPS. Take care. Com. I'm going to click add. I'm going to add this sitemap. Now, you may or may not recall a previous post that we did, previous video, where I showed you how to get the sitemap from Yoast SEO. Yoast SEO. So let me go here and show you just in case you skipped ahead. I'm going to go to Yoast. So I'm going to go here, right? See where it says SEO. I'm going to click on SEO. I'm going to click on General. I'm going to click on Features. I'm going to scroll down here to XML sitemaps. I'm going to click on question mark and then see the XML sitemap. And that's the good thing about Yoast is it automatically generates a sitemap for you. So that's not something that you have to worry about generating. So I'm going to add the sitemap. Add. Okay, the next thing it's going to ask me to do is add in a validation into the meta tag, the head tag. So if you may or may not recall this, this is how we do it. I'm going to copy the meta, this meta tag, so we can verify the ownership of the website, of the page. I'm going to be... Haha. Now see, this is something that's a little different that we've done. I've actually have a plugin on here that blocks my back end. So let me get off the screen real quick and we'll come right back. Let me see. Stop sharing. Or let me pull over here. So you won't see what I'm typing in. Give me just 1 second. Okay. Theme Editor is actually, Theme Editor is a plugin we use in order that if we close out the appearance editor, the editor for the appearance of the site, of the page, of the site, excuse me. And so we go to theme editor, and this is where we actually can edit. We would do exactly what we would be able to do in the appearance section. So let me go here to theme editor. Kevin? No, thanks. I gotta get enough of these. And I'm gonna go to the header. See right here, header. And look in the head. See, we have a Google site verification. There. I'm gonna go ahead and paste. And then I'm going to update the file. And now it's saved successfully. Now let's go back to Bing Webmaster and we're going to verify ownership. Let's see if it gives us a, it always does that, I promise you, man, every time. All right, we'll come back. We'll come back to that. Bing can be kind of wonky. It's Bingy. So, all right, so let's see if we have any. We can see where it's our keyword tracker is kind of thinking about it. Let's see if this ranks anywhere. I doubt it, but because it's a fairly new site, so it's got 480 searches, 100% difficulty, so it's a very difficult keyword to rank for. So, anyway, but it is something that I like that I'm want to test someone out on, and. I think it's a good opportunity to show you guys how to optimize a particular blog post for Google. So if you like this video, I definitely would love for you to hit like, share, and then, of course, you can click the subscribe link down in the description box. So go ahead and hit stop. Stop sharing and throw my peace sign. All right, y'all. Thanks a lot. Peace.